Hello once again, how are you? I hope, as always, you're in fine fettle. It's great to... I'm so looking forward to this today because the man beside me is a young gentleman I have been a fan of for years and years and years. The voice of Ireland.
I know, where did that come from? I think that came from...
It came from you.
It didn't, it came from the New York Times. It sounds like... It sounds like a political movement marching up and down O'Connell Street looking for workers' rights. So yeah, I'll still take it. It's a great compliment to have that title.
Absolutely, because you're talking to the voice of the Midlands, the Irish voice of the Midlands.
Midlands.
But not in pure singing voice. The voice that turns up everywhere with presidents and T-shirts and
the voice of the people.
Yeah. So I got that and I'm thinking, where did that come from? But I know that as well. But it's great to see you. Genuinely great to see you.
It's great to be here because I've watched this show over and over and over. And I've gone, why are they doing... Now I see why they're doing that. Oh, yeah. And now I'm here.
Yeah.
Now it took me half the day to get out here.
Exactly that. Yeah, he walked from Birmingham.
From Birmingham.
Yeah, we see.
I've just noticed something, actually, Rob. Sorry to interrupt. We're not moving, are we, on the video behind you?
I thought eventually we'll get to Inishgrown, but not just... Yeah, they were on the way now.
We're on the road again.
Hang on.
I thought you were still...
No. So hold on a minute.
Okay.
It's all right for your man here to go and have a glass of water, right?
Yeah.
Oh, you never said a dicky bird there, did you?
Well, but
you've even hid that behind there.
Yes, I have, yes, that's right. Sorry, Tommy, should I bring you water over?
No, it's okay. Bob knows me. I wouldn't even let somebody carry my bag, so I do my own things.
Absolutely.
I row my own boat all the time. I have done for the last 52 years, and I'm going to keep doing it.
And that's... Shout if you want your water.
Oh, shout if you want your water. I can't touch mine.
No, Tommy's more important here.
Listen, Fleming won't be here all the time, so I'm telling you now.
Oh, okay then.
Okay.
I'm saying nothing.
The rules in this programme are going to
change. So how long have you two been married?
You would think we were, wouldn't you?
Too long.
I was married for 18 months. Bless him, that's it. But we're just looking. He's got a photograph of you behind him all ready for you.
Oh, that's a young me.
Yeah. So, listen, do you mind if I start? We'll do a tune, and then we can have a chat. Play with Bright Blue Rose?
Yeah, absolutely.
Do you like...
That's one of my favourite songs. I've been singing that since I was 18.
Well, introduce it then.
So, yeah, Jimmy McCarthy, a songwriter from Cork, an amazing songwriter.
Great songwriter.
Who has written some of the most iconic songs of our time, like No Frontiers, Katie... Nadine, Bright Blue Rose, some of the most amazing songs. And I heard this song for the first time when I was 18 doing my Leaving Cert, the final year in school, sung by Christy Moore on the Voyage album. And I started singing it then, and I'm going to admit it, I am now singing it 34 years.
Really?
You can see everyone going...
So we'll get it right 52. Then.
Yes, absolutely. Get it right.
Let's have a listen to Tommy Fleming and Bright Blue Rose. Beautiful. I love it to bits.
I skimmed across black water without once submerging on the banks of an urban morning that hunger the first light much, much more than the mountains ever do. And she like a ghost beside me goes down with ease of a dolphin and emerges unlearned, unshamed of harm. For she's a perfect creature, natural in every feature, and I am the geek with the alchemist on. For life of others, and you'll find a very special heart. And it is a holy thing, and it is a precious time, and it is the only way. Forget me nots among the snow, it's always been, and so it goes. To ponder his death and his life eternal.
I love that song to bits. Gorgeous song.
It's, you know, it's an iconic song at this point. Yeah. And it's not just, but it's not me that just sang it. Like, you have Mary Black's version, you have Christy's version, you have...
A lot of people have
done it. A lot of people have done that song. And it's just, there's just something special about it.
Yeah, very, very special. I love it to bits, so there you go. Tommy Fleming's in the studio today, and it's a new Richard I've got here.
A new Richard?
He's a new Richard, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, he's not the old one. He's never worked like this before.
But I'm saying nothing. Because you know me, I walk into one of these situations and I'm going, oh, can we move the lighting over here? Can we do this? I'm saying nothing.
Oh, don't. If he moves half an inch, the whole world's gone wrong.
Yeah. I'm dreading that I've moved a smidgeon and I can't.
You've learned a new word today.
I've got my smidgeons sorted, Tommy, yes.
But let's talk a little bit more about you. Where did it all start? Are you from Inishgrown?
No. I'm from Clare, County Sligo. Inishgrown is 17 miles, which is about 20, we're in kilometres. So it's about 24 kilometres from Clare, where I grew up. As a kid growing up, every summer, my mum and dad would go to Inishgrown. Well, my dad would work on the council. So my mum, we would all, six kids and my mum, would be in a caravan. And we couldn't believe how much room we had.
Fantastic.
And it was mad. But my association and my love for the area is from growing up. There isn't a day that I don't run on the beach or run by the playground or any of that area without a major memory being evoked.
Really? Yeah. So do you remember then how we met in Inishgrown?
I do. on the beach.
No, I didn't meet you on the beach.
No, it was the two...
Graham and Judy.
Graham and Judy met.
They'd gone out for a walk.
Yeah, and then I was in the Diamond Coast.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I met you in the Diamond Coast.
That's right. Well, yeah. He rang me and he said, we're walking down here, Tommy Fleming's here on the beach. And you were down on the beach.
I was down on the beach and you rang me. You rang me and you said, what's the walk on the beach like? Who's watching me? And I thought, how the hell did he know that? And then we and Tina and I went down to the concert that night.
That's right, yeah.
I think I sang.
You did?
I sang. And
we were over doing, as usual, a Brolly charity night.
Yeah.
And we took a whole lot of people with us. But at the time, of course, was the volcano, wasn't it?
Oh, yes.
Oh, the Atlantic volcano.
That's right.
Because I was supposed to be playing Birmingham and it was cancelled.
Yeah, it's cancelled.
Town Hall was cancelled.
Yeah. So you were there and I'm thinking, well, he's on the beach and I was plugging it. And then, of course, no flight. So we were going with a plane load of golfers who couldn't fly over either. So in the end, it was like a proper disaster. But we know we rescued it. We got in and Brian at the Diamond Coast was wonderful. He worked with us. We went on the radio and said, look, we come over to do a charity event. We were buying guide dogs, two for Ireland and two for here. So we did. That song you sang that night, a couple of songs, Frank McCaffrey was with me and you helped to buy a couple of guide dogs for the blind.